Why do we take landscapes? Do you know what? It's a great question, and I can't speak for anyone else, but today we're going to explore why we do it. We'll take a look at composition and preferences and see what kind of photos we walk away with from the exact same locations.
Today's location is Clay next to the sea, which is home to arguably one of the most photographed landmarks in Norfolk. But for now, we've headed straight to the beach.
Okay, so we're here to explore why we take photos. That's pretty evident. And we know we're in Clay in Norfolk. There is a gorgeous windmill. You saw it when we come in. That is the hero shot here. But we thought, you know what? We parked up on the beach. Let's have a little look around and see what else there is. So I'm with Chris, who's the newest member of the team. And what do you think to this freezing cold location?
Well, I'd like to have done it in July when it was a bit warmer. But
touché.
Obviously quite a challenging location. Not much in terms of interest.
No, it's a bit.
We're at 11 o'clock, there or thereabouts, so the light is not ideal. So what we're going to do, we're both going to head off in opposite directions on this beach, see what we can find, what makes a good shot.
Yeah, it's pretty simple, so let's crack on. So I'm not really digging this much, but I think the reason we've come out to do this video today is because we're kind of exploring what photography is, and photography isn't going to Nepal to take that amazing shot of Everest, or photography isn't, you know, going to Lundhofen or Iceland just to take a fantastic portfolio of shots. Photography is all about exploring what you see, and that means going out and seeing something. And for us, we've gone really simple. This isn't the world's best photo. I'm not the world's best landscape photographer, but I'm coming at it with a few things in mind. There's a few things I want to explore. I'm trying with a tripod, but actually from a composition point, it's not giving me anything exciting. And it's not the world's most exciting scenery either, let's be completely honest. So I'm going to get around that slightly by taking the camera off and then just throwing it on the floor, which I'll do now. And just to figure out, I know how to use tripods, I've done this before. Just that little, yeah, there you go, that little thing, and I'm using the ridges here. We've got some more foreground interest. We've got that dramatic blue sky. I've got a six stop ND on there, and I've got the polarizer as well, so I can go down. The ND's not really gonna do much, there's no movement in the sky, but you know, the polarizer's gonna be the saturation. A little more interest in the shot. I've come to the front as well, so I'm not taking this side on, because side on is very messy there, it's a big blue sky, there's no drama to it. And just because you're shooting something that's maybe not interesting doesn't mean you can't find drama. So I'm getting my drama by going low down, getting a bit of a little foreground interest, a bit of blur in there. This is what it's all about, trying to find a shot and then put your own mark on it. And that is exactly what I'm trying to do without falling over.
Well, it's big, bold, simple and colourful, just like me. Is this my best shot? Not by a long shot, but I can see myself in it, and I think I managed to bring a bit of character out as well.
Do you know what one thing like a decade of photography has taught me? Is that we all have something different to bring to the table. Some of us are more creative, some of us are more technical, but the one thing that you really need to figure out is, what do you want from photography? What do you want photography to give you? What we need to do is stop and break it down and think, do I want to take this shot? Is this the shot that defines me as a photographer? Is this the shot that I want to take in this moment? And that's really the most important thing, because when it comes down to it, photography is an art form and it is an expression of who you are. And that's probably exactly what we're going to explore today. Why do I take the shot? Is that shot me? Can I make me in that shot?
We've chosen a tricky location here with very few points of interest.
There are, however, a lot of these kind of old boats, tractors, machines dotted about the beach. I've found myself here at this rather handsome looking boat, so I'm going to see what I can take. So I'm using a 16-35mm wide angle lens. landscape photography, quite good for that. Allows you to get nice and close to the subject, get you those nice vistas. I've set up down here. I quite like low angle photography when it comes to landscape. A couple of problems with doing this on this particular location with this boat. Actually, the main problem is that you don't get any sense that you're by the sea. The horizon's quite high, and actually there's the sea quite low behind these pebbles, this pebbled beach. So actually you don't get any concept that you're by the sea at all. Second issue, we are dealing with rather flat looking skies today, to be honest. It's nice over in that location, which I'll try and get some shots of in a minute.
As I've explained, I have a particular love of a low angle shot, largely due to the fact that this is generally not how people would normally observe a scene. I've reflected the minimalist nature of the location by leaving a lot of empty space in the composition.
Another great compositional technique is the use of leading lines. And actually what I've done is notice this mooring rope on the floor. And I'm going to see if I can use it as part of a composition just to really draw the viewer's eye into that image. What I've actually just discovered is actually what I can do is raise the rope up a bit to almost make it look like the boat is attached to the camera. So I've talked about not liking the composition from that side of the boat, obviously eliminating the sea, which is the whole kind of point of being at the sea, on the coast. What I thought I'd do is come around this side and actually see if I can get a bit of contrast in my composition. Actually, the irony of a boat on land just seemed to be quite appealing to me. So what I've done is I've come around this side. The problem is we've got the light, the sun shining right at us. So what I've had to do is I've had to put a graduating filter on the lens just to compensate and dull down some of that sunlight coming through. Still not particularly happy with the composition, however I've spotted a place over there that I might go just to see if I can add a bit of creativity to the shot. So as I explained, over there I'm struggling to get a fairly decent shot just due to the sky, not a lot in the background, the foreground. So what I've done is come over here on the edge of this marshland, and what I'm trying to do is frame it up so that we've got this brush in the foreground. And actually what I'm aiming for with the photo here is, as you can see, we've got quite a nice high bank, the boat sat on it, and actually to give that perspective of the boat on the horizon that you'd usually be accustomed to out there on the ocean. Couple of bits of advice I would give in this situation: when you've got a photo where you've got such a distinctive horizon, a couple of things I recommend. First thing is always on your tripod, make sure you've got your spirit level accurate, the bubble in the middle of the circle. Second thing, the camera, most modern cameras generally have a inbuilt artificial horizon tool, which you can access just by the on-screen display. If you press info a couple of times, depending on what model camera you've got, that just helps you identify whether you've got the horizon dead straight.
I feel that this resulted in a much more interesting shot. We've still got the lack of interest in the sky, so I decided to create some foreground interest by positioning the foliage of the marshland at the bottom of the composition.
Cheeky swat.
Come on, Kirk.
How'd you get on?
Yeah, we always knew it was going to be a difficult location to get any decent compositions, but we never came here for that, did we?
No, and I'm guessing because you know I got the better shot, you decided to leave me, but thanks for that. So let's grab some lunch and head off to get the hero shot.
Let's do it.
So, we've left the rather uninspiring beach location and made our way over to the famous clay windmill, after some fish and chips, of course. We've timed it perfectly for golden hour, so let's see what shots we can come up with.
The light here is stunning. This is one of the most overshot locations, I get that, and obviously this side is probably better for sunrise because the sun comes back behind me. and you've got everything perfectly illuminated. I'm going a little more artsy. And again, we're talking about why do we take the shot? And I don't necessarily want to take the shot that everyone else takes, but I want to take the shot that makes me just go, oh, boom. And for me, flare, light, golden hour, the three things that just absolutely make me so excited. And that is what I've got here. So yeah, I've got a bit of a silhouette, but I'm going to bracket around that. I've got an ND on here as well, so it's going to cut out some of the light, and a polarizer just to help. And I'm hoping when the sun goes a little bit lower and just crests over the trees as well, you're going to have a bit more richness to the sky. Maybe just catch the blue hour a little bit and I'll get that shot and it'll be nice and I won't have the flare in anything. So I'm covering both bases. I've gone 56 and do you know what? I really like the wide angle. And I'm probably going to switch back to the wide angle, get a bit closer as well. And then you've got the whole lead, and it's a tenuous lead to be fair, but you've got this whole lead of the river coming through just to the the windmill. And it really makes it for me. Yeah, you know, it'd be nice if the light was hitting it and there was a bit more light. And again, you know, this is the point. Why do I choose this? Because I like it. That's why I'm choosing it. I don't want to win awards. I don't want anyone's praise. I want to walk out of here from a location that's incredibly well shot and say to myself, Kirk, you've got a shot that you like. And that's exactly what you should do. That's what we should all do. We should go out, shoot for ourselves, and just enjoy the experience as much as the final shot.
So I'm on the other side of the river to Kirk, looking at this wonderful windmill behind us. We're at golden hour, and we still find ourselves in a pretty unique situation in the UK where we've got no cloud cover. All that's going to mean is that we're not going to be able to create any dynamic skies in our composition. So what I'm going to look for is, again, as I mentioned earlier, looking for that foreground interest and really something that I can make my shots look quite interesting. I've spotted some opportunities over there. I'm going to go over there now and just take a look. So one thing I like to do is look for unique opportunities in terms of how you can compose your shots. Now, it's the UK, it's been raining a lot lately. What I've noticed is quite a lot of puddles on the floor. So what I'm going to try now is to get some reflection shots of the fantastic windmill.
Using reflections is a great way of adding additional interest into your composition and can result in some pretty amazing shots. If you're fortunate enough to own a camera with a rotating touchscreen, then this is much easier, as you can get the perfect view of your composition from anywhere. I didn't have that luxury on this occasion. The windmill was slightly too far away from the shallow puddle, meaning that it was difficult to get the camera low enough to feature the entire windmill in the reflection.
Okay, so what I've done here is come down amongst the brush. We've just lost the sun, but fortunately, just before I was able to get a few shots, what I've done is put a nice soft focus in the foreground elements, really put the emphasis on the focus on the windmill. Bit of a surprise happening right now. What we've done is lucked out. We've got the first full moon of the year appearing just over the horizon there. So what I'm doing now is waiting for 5-10 minutes or so for that moon to be fully in shot, and then hopefully I've got a nice shot with the moon in the background of the windmill. Something I didn't really expect.
As we've explored in this video, there is no right or wrong way to take a landscape photo. Yes, there are some pretty fundamental technical aspects such as focus and exposure you need to get right, but when it comes down to it, it's up to you what you want to shoot and how you want it to look.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget, if you enjoyed this, click subscribe, click the bell for notifications, and give us a like whilst you're at it. Don't forget to check out all the other great videos we're putting out there for you.